food. We all eat it, but we can't agree on what's good for us and what isn't. For decades, Americans have been searching to find which foods are healthful, and we've only gotten sicker. Worse, the food industry misleads us for profit by marketing different foods as healthy each year, and makes contradictory claims about them. So what should we eat? Who should we listen to? Government? Scientists? The food industry? Your neighbor? Your grandma? Newspapers? The internet? Robert Atkins? Or how about Grok?
This is Grok. He is our ancestor. He's strong, healthy, and hunts mammoths. We know Grok didn't have modern foods like refined sugar, vegetable oils, and grains. In fact, he ate a diet of whole, nutrient-dense animal and plant foods, otherwise known as real foods. Real food for Grok was generally seasonal and local. Duh. It was also organic, and it was minimally processed. As we'll see, humanity gradually moves away from real foods. Sometime after, Grok's descendant, Manzor, and other humans left the hunter-gatherer lifestyle to settle in towns and cities. After settling, Manzor began to grow food through agriculture, also known as farming. With farming, a few new foods came about for the first time in human history: dairy, grains, and legumes.
Up until the Industrial Revolution, people used mainly saturated and monounsaturated cooking fats, like in lard, olive oil, and coconut oil. But in the 1800s, polyunsaturated fats in industrial seed oils became popular in Western diets. These oils cannot be considered real because they require large amounts of processing by heavy machinery. On the other hand, people have for millennia used simple tools to squeeze oils from the palm fruit, coconut, olive fruits, and sesame seed. In addition to unreal oils, the consumption of processed white flour and sugar increased rapidly. Dr. Ansel Keys published a 7-country study using incomplete data to conclude that saturated fat leads to high cholesterol, which in turn leads to heart disease, otherwise known as the diet-heart hypothesis. Since Keyes' study, the public has wrongly demonized saturated fat and cholesterol, overlooking studies that contradict his hypothesis.
In the past, we hunted, gathered, and in most cases farmed real food on small scales, preserving the health of soil and ecosystem. We ate what was available to us and thrived, but in the blink of an eye, we've become confused about what to eat and our food system is broken. Now we pack livestock into unhealthful conditions, feed them unnatural diets, and pump them with chemicals. We farm crops using excessive amounts of water and resources, depleting the soil faster than it can be replenished. What can we do as consumers to reclaim our health and rebuild the food system? If you don't cook, start. Eat with your friends and family when you can. Buy as much food as possible from your local farmers market. Avoid center aisles when at a supermarket. The real food is usually on or near the walls. When buying food with labels, stand under 5 ingredients. If the food has a health claim, don't buy it. If it does not spoil, do not eat it.
Get real. Don't wait to make the better choice.